all projects are coming down to the human element. AI is not gonna do everything for us. I think it's great, but I don't think it's gonna be the Terminator. You know, I mean, we need a project manager maybe that is the Terminator.
I'll be back.
But it's not gonna do everything for us. EI is internal, what you need, the self-awareness. Why do you feel this way? Why are you mad? Why are you sad? You know, whatever that may be, by really understanding and looking at our emotions and how do we cope with that. And then self-regulation, when you have that urge to respond, but you're intelligent enough to know that's not how you should respond. It's not always what you say, but how you say it. So by having that self-regulation, a little self-control. And then external, we have empathy. We have to understand or try to understand why people are behaving that way. There may be something in their life that's happening we know nothing about that's affecting how they behave at work or in your project. And then social skills, the ability to have a conversation, to interact with others, to have active and effective listening. Project success largely comes down through leadership. Leadership does not have to be the project manager. Leadership is the person that aligns and motivates and directs. It's often seen as the project manager, but we've seen more of this over the years about emergent leadership, where anyone can become a leader. So we think about the complex human dynamics, about the communication challenges, our relationships among stakeholders, not just us, but among stakeholders, and how there may be some politics and power dynamics happening there. And then we can get into the whole conversation, which we won't, but just hit the headlines here about leadership and management. Leadership is about aligning and motivating and to get people to want to do the work to achieve that business value, the importance of the project. I pause because this is going to sound really mean, but it's called project management, not project leadership. Project management is very simply about getting things done. Now, can you manage a project without leadership? Of course you can, because you can have coercive power. You can have that command and control mindset. It's not always effective. People are going to act out of fear, not out of desire. We truly need both. We need leadership and we need management. And to have both, we have to have emotional intelligence. So we need that human element in our project team. So how we lead our team and how we manage our team. I know people say, oh, you lead people, manage things. It's about getting things done. You can get caught up in the, you know, the semantics of it there, but we're managing our team. If you're a manager, you're not just managing things, you're managing people. But you also want to lead people. That's the emotional intelligence. Our team members have diverse backgrounds. They come from all different walks of life, all different cultures, and all different value systems. So they have diverse backgrounds. So emotional intelligence helps us to better interact and to understand and to have social skills of all the people on our team. So we think about the different personalities. I mean, sometimes you have an individual that, you know, they hate the project, they don't want to be there, they don't like their job, and then you have other people that they're very excited, they're thankful for the opportunity, they have a cheery, upbeat disposition. So you think about the personalities, the perspectives. You have those people that they don't understand why we're doing this. I'll do it, but I don't know why. Their contributions. So some people contribute a lot, and you have other people that contribute very little. And then what are their different strengths that they bring to the project? So then we have to think about our team's culture, but also the organizational culture. So we want inclusivity. You ever go into those teams where you've got these little cliques where people don't feel involved or left out? And then the psychological safety, that I want to have some ability to behave without a fear of retribution. A long time ago, when I was in college in Knoxville, I worked in a print shop. And in this print shop, the guy who owned it was just a jerk. I mean, he would just yell and stomp and, you know, just had no problem climbing all over you. Just kind of a beast of a guy to work with. And the one thing that I learned from that job is that I don't want to treat people that way. A couple of his pressmen just quit. They left him stranded. And so, you know, it was, they just had enough of his behavior that they didn't want to continue. And then eventually I quit, obviously, as well. But the psychological safety is important. How we treat others is so important. And then we think about our intelligence, but we need to respect the intelligence of other people. We want to be creative. I believe that project management is creative. It's like playing chess, but you don't necessarily have all the pieces. So you have to be creative to get things done. Communication styles. So like this is a communication style. We have written, we have those ad hoc meetings, you have formal presentations. All of those are communication styles. And then based on your career, as you move forward in your career or in an organization, you begin to develop some friendships and some affiliations with others and some alliances with others. So that interpersonal relationships, that's all part of emotional intelligence. We probably have all seen Maslow's hierarchy of needs. I think it's a fundamental concept for emotional intelligence, but also for how we behave and why we work. So if we look at Maslow's hierarchy of needs, starting there at the bottom with physiological, safety, social, your esteem, all the way up to your purpose or calling, self-actualization. With each one of those levels, we think about as an individual, I can't go to the level above until the level below is met. So for example, if you're out in the desert, and you're dying of thirst, you know, you're not really concerned about making friends right now. So you need the physiological needs. You need some water and shade and some suntan lotion or what have you. So at each level of that, there is a human element that's tied to it. So then as I created this presentation, I thought, well, how does AI fit within Maslow's hierarchy of needs? Can AI give me physiological needs? Can it give me food and water? Not really. We might be able to leverage it to get money to buy food and water, but does it really give me physiological needs? Does it give me safety needs? Well, maybe when it comes to things like analyzing risk. Can AI help me make friends? Oh no, we've seen AI in social media. We're seeing that more and more with websites like chatbots, but you can generally tell it's fake. Esteem needs. Can AI make me feel better about what I've accomplished? I think yes, because I can use AI to create scripts and to automate things, and I can be proud of the work that I've done or that AI did for me. But can AI help me be self-actualized? I don't know about that one. I don't know. So what do you think about this? This is just something I've been pondering lately about, hey, how does AI, a robot, a machine, fit in with Maslow? So I think that's interesting, and maybe that'll keep you awake this evening. The whole crux of our conversation today, I'll leave you with this, comes down to the three things that we need to be a successful project manager or successful person, I could even say. Is we need empathy, the ability to understand others' perspectives and background and why they behave and act the way they are, about really understanding where they may be coming from. Collaboration. Projects are very rarely a solo activity, that we want to collaborate and work with others towards a common result, towards that business value. And then as a project manager, I want ethical decision-making. And of course, ethics have been a very big conversation. We've seen this over and over when it comes to using AI. You know, some of the scary answers that AI has given people that they've put in. So we have ethical decision-making in EI and in AI.